All he could think about was, I'm too young for this. Got my whole life ahead. Hell, I'm just a kid myself.
So what's going on, guys? This is Davis back again with another commentary over some work that I did today. I made this video quite a bit longer than the normal ones. Usually I try to run the videos around like 7 to 8 minutes, maybe six. But I did this one at 23 for a couple reasons. First, I got a lot to talk about. And second, you know, it's my fucking channel. I'll do what the fuck I want. All right, well, I got a specific subject that I was wanting to talk to you guys about today, and it's kind of awkward for me to do because, you know, my dad's right next door and can probably hear everything I'm saying, but fuck it, I'm going to do it anyway. I made a commitment to do this channel and run this channel, and by God, I'm going to fucking run it. So, what I'm talking about today is, how am I set up this little tripod? I don't think I can. Yeah, I can. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to talk to you guys about my first love and my experience with my first love and where it's gotten me today and why sometimes it works out and why sometimes it doesn't work out. So a little bit of a backstory. I'm not going to get too far into this, but I met this girl. She was actually my boss, and me and her hooked up and have been off and on for almost 4 years. Okay, that's a pretty long time. So since I was probably about like 16, 17 to now when I'm like 20, me and her have been off and on. She was my first love, and the funny thing is I actually have her name tattooed on my leg. Don't ever do that, guys. That is a horrible bit of advice. Never tattoo some chick's name or some dude's name on your leg or on any part of your body. You will regret it. I promise you. All right. Well, getting into what I was trying to talk about. Me and this girl have been off and on for 3 to 4 years. We have a really complicated relationship. It started with me and her working together. We both worked in the same place. She was my boss, and we kind of fell in love with each other, I guess, quote unquote. It was pretty real. And what ended up happening is I ended up moving in with her and her mom in this two bedroom apartment, and I probably lived there with them for about 8 months. Okay, I did eventually get kicked out, which is, you know, along the lines, I'll get to that. But while I was living with her for this 8 months, it was the happiest 8 months of my entire life. Like, when I tell you it was the happiest 8 months of my entire life, I absolutely 100% mean that. I've never been happier in my life than the 8 months I spent with her and her mom in that two-bedroom apartment. All right. So, how I got into the apartment. Well, me and her started, you know, being intimate or whatever, and her mom didn't, you know, we started doing it in my car. I'm going to be honest. We started fucking in my car. And her mom called us one time and said that there's no reason for y'all to be, you know, sleeping in his car and, you know, being intimate in his car or whatnot. And, you should just come up in the apartment and, you know what, he can stay the night. Okay, well, I took that the completely wrong way. I took that completely wrong. In my mind, stay the night meant, like, I don't have to leave. I didn't have a bad family life or a bad house to live in. Everything was fine, you know. In my household, everybody kind of leaves each other alone, and there's the occasional fucking blow-up fight, right? It's not that bad at all, at all. But she said I could stay, and I've always been looking for a way out. I've been looking, you know, to get out of my house. That was like, that was like the goal. So, she said stay. I was like, okay, stay for good. So I kind of moved in. I moved all my fucking clothes in. I moved half my shit in. I moved everything into this house, right? And for a while, it worked out really great because her mom, you know, they loved the shit out of me for a while. I can honestly say they loved the shit out of me. It was great. You know, I did the dishes. I walked their dog. I moved all their shit from one house into that apartment. Okay, like all free labor. I didn't get paid for any of this. I mean, like, I was living with them, and no, I did not pay rent, but I bought all the groceries. So it worked out for a really long time. And what ended up happening is that, you know, her stepdad would come over, and her stepdad was, you know, really pissed that I was there. Okay, he was pissed because her and her mom and her stepdad have a really complicated relationship, even more complicated than me and hers. But basically, they were separated, and he would come over. He was paying for the apartment, and he would come over and hang out for a little bit, and then we wouldn't see him for, like, you know, a couple days, and it would just be me, her, and her mom. And he was getting pissed off because I was spending more time with his wife and his daughter than he got to. Okay. So I'm living in this apartment. Everything's going great. All of a sudden, they're like, let's take a trip to Florida. Okay, so I was like, oh, this is going to be killer. They took me with them, of course, you know. So I went on this trip to Florida. It's me, my girlfriend. We have our own room, you know. I mean, back then, it was like we were inseparable. Okay, like anywhere she went, I went. Anywhere I went, she went. It's just the way it was. And, you know, keep in mind, I was only 17, and she was only 18, and, so what ended up happening on this trip to Florida is that on the way back, they basically, told me that I was being kicked out, and they did it through their daughter, which was kind of ridiculous. They had, my girlfriend come up to me and just tell me that I can't stay there anymore. I gotta move all my shit out. You know, and basically it went from seeing, this is literally how it went. It went from us seeing each other every single day, 24 hours a day, to, and this kind of hurts me on the inside to say this, but they literally wanted to take that time and then make it one day a week. So just think about that. Think about two 16-year-old kids who know nothing about the world, who are fucking madly in love with each other, and they're seeing each other all the time. You know, can't like breathe without each other. And then they take all that away, and they give you one day. So you can obviously imagine my reaction. I was very fucking mad. I was so furious. I didn't understand. I thought maybe I did something wrong or something along those lines. I just was so fucked up. I didn't know what to think or what to do or how this was going to last. So we went on dating for probably about 2 or 3 weeks after that. You know, her birthday was coming up, and they invited me over for her birthday so we could go out or whatever, and it just wasn't the same. It was like I walked in there, and I automatically felt awkward. I felt like I was being soloed out because I'd just been kicked out, and here I am coming over for her birthday in the same room that used to be our room, and now it's back to her. It wasn't something I would want to go through twice. So we went out for her birthday, and she still remembers this. I was so mad on her birthday, and I really regret that. I shouldn't have been. I should have just, like, you know, manned up and accepted that it was her birthday, and I should be happy it's her birthday. But I was pissed, dude. I was pissed. Like, I just lived with y'all for, like, a year. And I just got kicked out abruptly, and nobody wants to talk about that at all, really. Nobody. Y'all just want to act like y'all didn't do it and fuck our relationship all to hell. But what ended up happening is, again, I was looking for a way out because I didn't feel comfortable, you know, staying where I live. And, you know, and I had it so good with them, I just wanted a way out at this point again. So, my dad was currently living in Florida, and he made me a job offer. He said, you know what, come down here, you know, you getting rowdy. Because after I got kicked out, I kind of, you know, went partying a lot, you know, trying to take my mind off everything. And my dad said, you know, come down to Florida, you know, do some work, whatever. Went down to Florida, probably stayed there for about 8 months, didn't talk to her. I actually broke up with her. It was heartbreaking. I drove over to her apartment, and she had my bag. She had my bag with the rest of my stuff in it, and I stepped, like, she had these stairs going up to her apartment. I was at the bottom of the stairs, and she threw my bag with all my shit in it. She threw it down the stairs, and it landed on my feet. And I was like, okay, wow. Well, thank you for that. So, long story short, me and her broke up. We broke up that day. And, you know, it was really emotional for both of us. And I even called my mom. And as soon as that happened, I drove straight to Florida and didn't talk to her for 8 months. No contact with her whatsoever. Just cut her off. And honestly, to be completely honest with you, and this is going to sound horrible, I kind of forgot everything that was happening. I was in a whole new world, dude. I was in Florida. My dad showing me the ropes on how to do work and this and that. And she wasn't on my mind. So 8 months down the road, I get a text from her that says, you know, something about smoking pot. It was like, yeah, I started smoking pot. Can you get me some pot? And something like that. And, I went over to her apartment and, to bring her the pot or whatever. 'Cause back then I was very pot enthusiast. Like, I had it all the time. I'm sorry. I'm getting a little bit emotional thinking about this next part because I haven't thought about it in a long time. But I walked into her apartment, and I saw a skeleton of what she used to be. She was so malnourished and ridiculously skinny, and when she saw me, she just started crying, and it was really horrible. She just looked sick, and she wanted to cook for me for some reason. I don't know why. And she burned everything, but it was just really, really sad to see her like that. And, I didn't think there was any way. I left again. I saw her like that, and I pussied out instead of saying, you know, I can help you or something like that, or let's work this out or something. I left again. As soon as me and her got done doing whatever the fuck we were doing, I left. And I went back to Florida. And that fucked my head up bad. I went back to Florida and tried to work like I had been doing for the past 8 months. And I couldn't do anything except think about her. And what I saw when I went back, and it broke my fucking heart, dude. So I ended up like trying to fix things with her, and to be honest with you guys, it's never been the same since the first time we got together. And I think me and her are both trying to keep something alive that's been dead for a while. But it is what it is. Maybe one day we'll get it. So we got back together, and once we got back together, everything was just batshit crazy. It wasn't, we were lying to each other, a lot, and, that was bad. And, here's the crazy part. We broke up again, and then we got back together again, and we broke up again, and then we got back together, and she moved in with me. She moved in with me. So, for about 6 months, me and her were living together, and at this point in time, I had fried my brain, like, literally fried my brain with a whole bunch of things, you know, different substances that I'm not really gonna get into, but I fried my fucking brain in half. Like, I didn't know how to act around her at all. I was so mad at her because I felt like she was cheating on me all the time, or there was something she wasn't telling me, and I felt, because I was such a horrible person while we weren't together, that she was an even worse person. I don't know, just a whole bunch of crazy shit. So, long story short, me and her started talking again, and this time, you know, I really would like to make it right, but I don't know if it's even gonna go that way. I kind of grew up, you know. I've got my own things going on. You know, I'm doing what I love. I love making these videos, and I like working with my dad, but I really want to focus on these videos and let these videos take me somewhere and get me out of this rut, you know, like, to where maybe I don't have to work my entire life, you know, like, maybe I can just do these videos, edit these videos, you know, like, portray my life, kind of like, you know, famous vloggers do, I guess. But, that's kind of where I want to go with all this. I got my own stuff going on now, and, like, I'm gonna tell y'all why. I got about 5 minutes to explain what's happened. So, fast forward to 2016, or whatever today is. I think it's, I don't know what the date is, but, me and her, I got a hotel. She came and visited me in the hotel, and, me and her were talking, said, you know, let's try this again, or whatnot, or let's do this again. And the only thing is that I'd move from Florida to Georgia, like, constantly. I'm always going, like, I'll be in Georgia for a certain period of time, and then I'll go back to Florida for a certain period of time, and it's kind of at random. I don't really know, you know. I just go. So, me and her, you know, got together while I was in Georgia, and, we said, let's go ahead and do this. I made a promise to her that I'm done being a fucking whore. I'm done, you know, with all my little playmates, I guess. I don't need them, and I don't want them, and I'm over that, and, let's really try to do it again, because I really think I'm ready this time. And honestly, I really do think I'm ready. I'm sober. That's something new. I'm sober for the most part, and my head's a lot more clear. Like, I really think freely, and I think that I could really do it upright this time. But so I went down to Florida, and, you know, I was like, I gotta keep contact with her. I mean, that's the most important thing. I gotta talk to her on a daily basis. I gotta, like, make sure me and her are slowly falling for each other again, and that's what's gonna bring that spark back, that spark that we lost. And, So that's what I tried to do. I was texting her every day and keeping up with her. And, you know, I mean, I still talk to other people, not like other girls, but I mean, I talk to like friends. I talk to other friends, you know, they kind of keep me sane. But I'm mostly talking to her, you know, she's my main priority. I got 2 minutes to do this. Well, anyway, today, I have no connection where I live. I have no service where I live. So, for 2 days I didn't talk to her, and then I tried to, get in contact with her today and no response. Like, she sent me a ton of messages and she is obviously very pissed off at me, and that could be the end of it, guys. That's what I'm thinking. And if it is, that's a horrible way to go out, but I guess that's the way it's going to be done. Thank y'all for staying with me and listening to all this bullshit. I think I'm going to title this video like First Love Edition or something like that. I don't know. It just depends what I throw together. It's going to take forever to fucking process this thing because it's so damn long. But this is just a little special. I'm going to go back to making, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 minute videos and just talking over those. But I think this will help with my commentary and everything, and it's something that I really wanted to talk about and address. And just if y'all have any first love stories or something like that, drop me a comment in the comment box. And if you don't mind, right next to that comment box there's this little button that says subscribe. If you wouldn't mind clicking that button, it's free. I promise you don't have to pay for nothing. All you got to do is click that button. That would be great. But I hope you guys enjoyed this very depressing little vlog or day in the life of a construction worker. And like I said, you know, if you got anything that you want to say or any kind of story you want to tell or whatever, if you got a similar experience, if you got a different experience, if you got an experience that blows mine out of the water, hit me with it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'm going to go ahead and end this here. Peace out, and I'll see you in the next one.